controlled type of detonation.
And I've got to tell you too, Richard, 80% of my respondents here, 80% of our listeners who are writing in, agree with you that there's something very strange here and that we should have a new investigation. And I think that's what you're asking for. What are the chances of getting it?
Oh, well, there's zero if most of the listeners do nothing. And that has been the biggest problem in America. Most people do nothing. We're trained. It's as if we're engineered by the media or something to not take action, to not be civically active. This is extremely important for us. It's a duty of every citizen to question our government. The government should fear its people. The people should not fear the government. When we see multi-ton steel sections ejected laterally at 600 feet out of the sides of the Twin Tower, instantly at 50 to 70 miles per hour, we should question our government. I mean, we have huge problems that are obvious, and we have to act on this information. This is what makes us citizens. We have to care about the first responders who are dying by the hundreds, and hundreds and hundreds of them very sick because they were told that the air is safe to breathe. And indeed, it was not. It's known that there's tons of asbestos, and I would encourage all of your listeners to support the Feel Good Foundation, which is one of the key organizations doing so much work on behalf of the ailing first responders. So that's www.feelgoodfoundation, F-E-A-L, goodfoundation.com. John Feel is doing incredible work with this organization.
Let's go to Los Angeles now. Michael on the wild card line. Michael, good morning.
George, Richard.
Hi.
When Germany invaded Russia, they used to send back films of the troops bathing in the water of the frozen tundra, laughing and boasting in arrogance, and then Goebbels would show those in Germany and assure the German people that everything is fine. Now, that was their government's version of events, and I believe that those who believe the U.S. government version of 9/11 are like the German people at that time, fixed to take a bath, just like the Germans on the Russian front or at Nuremberg. It is so transparent that 9/11 was set up to give the ruling class a leg up on the world situation that existed at that time without the constraints of representative government, without government obstructing them in their personal graft, giving them a platform to set up psychological warfare operations here in the United States on the people of this country through the Patriot Act, Police Act, warrantless wiretaps, intimidation, jingoism, you name it. They're following the Hitler playbook all over with the cults of personality, and Obama's just a pause in that plan. The next wave is coming, whether it be another accident, if you will. But I just, you know, people say, why are you saying this? You know, you could get yourself in hot water, and, you know, hell's got cold water, and I just don't want to go there. We got a lot of problems in this world. There is genuine threats. But the people that are running the show have no credibility, and they are not deserving of the trust of any of us. And I think that I thank you guys for being very courageous. Everybody in the country agrees with you guys, you know? They're just not getting the coverage.
That's so true.
Well, why aren't we getting the coverage? Let's talk about that. William Colby, the former director of the CIA, said, interestingly enough, the Central Intelligence Agency owns everyone of any significance in the major media. That is a chilling statement in and of itself.
Well, I don't know about that. I'm in the major media, and they don't own me.
Well, so maybe we're talking about the mainstream news anchors where we get most of our information outside of evening talk shows. After all, William Colby was murdered in a very suspicious boating accident shortly after making this incredibly revealing statement. Google Operation Mockingbird.
I know. Thursday, I've got a couple guests on. We're going to talk about the very strange deaths of microbiologists all around this planet. I mean, there is a picture here. Michael from Los Angeles is absolutely right. We've talked about it before. There's something going on. The question is if you're all correct about 9/11 and how it unfolded, why did they need to do that in order to get the kind of power they've always had? You know,
well, maybe they didn't have enough power. Maybe they needed to consolidate it. A real investigation into the technical evidence found at our website, ae911truth.org, will get us the answers to a lot of these questions. We'll find out who benefited.
I'm going to send everybody to your website, Richard, and shut it down because of a massive amount of millions of people hitting your server. That's what's going to happen.
Uh-oh. We'll also find out. Flip my mind. Go ahead, George.
All right. Next up, let's go to Dayton, Ohio, east of the Rockies. Hello, Jeff.
Hey, thanks for taking my call, George.
Sure.
Hey, question for both of you. First, I want to know if you even heard these reports, and if so, what would be your take on reports that on the night of September 10th, 2001, that all the lights in the World Trade Center were shut off.
That's true. That is true. And the security cameras. Everything went down. Richard, you've heard that.
I have heard reports of this. I don't have the documentation for it. I would like to have that. If you could get that to us, that would be very helpful.
You take email on that website?
Yeah, there's a contact us button. Which is the way to contact us.
Let's go to San Diego, west of the Rockies. Go ahead, Tom.
Well, hi. It's a night for Tom calls.
It is.
My opinion and then an engineering question.
All right.
My opinion is there was a in Italy, there was a team of world leaders that was protected from another aircraft attack a couple years before 9/11. And then 5 weeks before 9/11, there is that document briefed to the president that bin Laden determined to strike in America. And there was this plan in Southeast Asia to use aircraft as weapons. So we all knew that was a possibility. Let me take a breath here.
Okay, sure.
Well, my engineering question is, how much fuel was on each of the planes? Was that enough to let the towers burn for an hour? Was there enough other combustible material inside of the one or two floors that were actually impacted to create the heat to melt that metal the way that they're claiming?
Yeah. Well, let's talk about that. The official story tells us that the fuel, most of it, 80 to 90% of it, was burned up outside the building. That's important. And the rest of the fuel burned up within 10 minutes. So no matter how much fuel there was, how many thousands of gallons, it burned up in 10 minutes. After that, we have normal office fires that were simply ignited by the jet fuel. And these office fires, in the case of the South Tower, pretty much burned out by the time, 56 minutes later, that the towers down. There's only enough fuel in a normal office to allow an area to burn for about 20 minutes. And then the fire moves on looking for fresh new fuel sources, leaving the area burned out behind, which is why when you have a building that collapses due to fire, you have large gradual deformations that follow the path of least resistance they fall over, but never in a steel frame high-rise building. Ever have we had fire bring one down because the steel structure in these buildings is enormous. It's a massive 100,000-ton heat sink directing heat away from the source of the energy, a source of the heat. So this is why we don't have buildings falling down, even though we have fires 10, 20 hours long in multiple floors.
You know, with the millions of dollars on bin Laden's head, why can't we get this guy? Why can't we find him? It doesn't make any sense either. I mean, we've got the technology to spot a frog on a sidewalk from space. It just doesn't make any sense. Next.
Well, I think we need him. That's why we haven't got him.
Let's go to a bad guy. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Greg, you're up with us. First-time caller. Hey, Greg.
Good morning. Morning. Listen, I shouldn't say this, but I'm part German, so you'll probably understand where I'm coming from. Let's say that he is right, that there was a controlled demolition of these three buildings. Now, you said you had a company in your town, George, where you lived, that had, you know, they're one of the world's largest demolitions.
Yep.
I've watched programs about demolition, and I'm not an expert, but usually when they demolition anything that is in concrete, they break through the concrete so they can get to the rebar to make sure they get a break. When they do the steel, they cut the steel to make sure. And you said that the gentlemen that were working on the projects in the elevators got out of the buildings before they collapsed. So where are the witnesses that say, hey, last night we weren't working over there, but when we came in this morning, there was new cement. Or this area over here, there's a whole bunch of stuff here that wasn't here last night. There's no witnesses to say, we saw people or we saw something that didn't look right, that there was charges put there. You're talking small thermite charges. There'd have to be thousands of them to bring those buildings down.